I know you think you're alone in this world, Lincoln, but you're not. And you never will be.
Oh, man. I gotta keep going? I need some, gunnage. I think. Wait, he's just standing up there. He's just standing, right? There's no other dudes in here? Really? I can't run. So, I can't even sneak. So, it looks like I don't have any choice but to come up here and confront Mark. Look at my angry walk. I'm so angry.
Hell of a sight, ain't it? When I first come to this town, it was nothing more than a backwater shithole. Now look at it.
Let me see your hands.
Whatever was between us is over, you understand? It ended the second it was you coming up them stairs instead of my son. You want a drink?
All right.
Had this imported from Scotland. Single malt. Now, usually I'm a bourbon man, but I figured I'd order something with a little more class for when the casino opened. Not much of a chance of that happening now, is it?
Doesn't look that way.
Take a seat. I ain't going nowhere. Hey, not bad.
I think I still prefer shine.
You know, a month or so after my brother Lucho died, I started having nightmares. I had this one where I was on a boat. Giant wave come, knocked my ass overboard. I hit that water and sink like a goddamn rock. There was another one where cotton mouths biting me all to hell. But the one that really got to me was Georgie's funeral. He's laid out in that shitty little casket. Neck cut, same as Lucho's. Yeah, that one really got to me. It'll come around again every 3 or 4 days.
That one where I'm back in Nam, sleeping in a foxhole. And all of a sudden, these dark figures come out of the shadows. I try to fight them off, but they hold me down, tie my hands together, stuff a muddy rag in my mouth so I can't scream, can't warn the men sleeping next to me. And then I gotta listen as all those men die.
Imagine that's not gonna go away anytime soon.
No. I imagine it won't.
And then this. This was all to try to keep mine from coming true. Look how that turned out. I buried a lot of people. More than I can count. The one I never wanted to see go down in that cold ground was my son.
And yet here we are.
Yes, sir. Here we are. My son is dead. And I'm having a drink with his killer. I'm not gonna apologize for what I did, you understand? If I did, I'd just be lying. I don't have it in me to feel shame for the things I've done to others. Never have.
Didn't come here for an apology.
Nah. I know you didn't. Goddamn, I was right about you, wasn't I? knew it the second I fucking saw you at the country club. Men like us, we're just wired up wrong. Only one thing we know. One thing we're good at. I'm gonna be waiting for you, Lincoln Clay. This won't be the last time we see each other.
I know.
What are you waiting for? Fucking do it. Finish this, you fucking...
Oh! If that's the only goal, that... Yeesh. Marcano, I love you. Here we go.
Take it you're Lincoln Clay.
So they tell me.
I told Sal this fucking casino would be the end of him. I meant it figuratively. This shit has a way of turning on you, doesn't it?
Especially if you piss off the wrong person.
You know who I am, son?
Guessing you're Leo Galante.
Take a little walk, you and me. Probably no surprise, but the rest of the commission wants you dead. You and anybody else that had anything to do with this.
What happened here was between me and Marcano.
I understand that, son. We all do. But this business makes you paranoid, irrational. They see Sally a pile of shit. They start wondering if someone's gonna serve them a plate of their own.
So you're here to decide if you're coming after me?
No. I'm here to deliver a message. You made your point, son. This all ends right here. Right now.
I got no quarrel with y'all.
Once a month, Sal kicked up 20% of his net. Cash only. Same man's been delivering it for, I don't know, 20 years or so. I see no need in deviating from that, do you?
No, sir.
In exchange, you run things as you see fit. Want to sell heroin? Want a whorehouse on every other corner? Makes no fucking difference to me. The only thing that matters is 20%.
And what if I decide to walk away? Leave all this behind?
Then this will be the last time we see each other. Best of luck to you, son.
Well, I thought that was going to be it. I thought that was the end. We killed the bad guy. I owe 20% to that knucklehead, but looks like we've got a current objective. Talk to Donovan, or they bury you. So let's go ahead and go there, and I'll be right back. Woo, man, that last mission. Sheesh. Alrighty, here we are to talk to, I don't know if this is Donovan or Father James or both. We'll find out.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So, what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over. Done. Finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's gonna shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't gonna be me, it's gonna be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Thank you. You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California, leave all this behind, and just start all over?
Yeah.
Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go. And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
Father.
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
Oh man, decision. Take the throne or leave town.
When after all, it was you and me. Let me please introduce myself. I'm a
throne
man of wealth and taste. I lay traps for troubadours who get killed before they reach Bombay.
You know what? Let's leave town. Leave New Bordeaux. Yeah. Man, all right. Well, I guess I'm going to leave town. I don't know if that's the right thing to do. Lincoln may have been onto something when he said that the person who takes his place could be someone worse, but at the same time, I didn't come back from the war to start a new war and to fight a new one. As far as I'm concerned, the war is over. And I gotta go before it starts up again. I think this is the ending. Mayan. Landing of Lincoln Clay. Played by Eduardo. Now this game. Oh no, oh no, oh no! Dog. Doggone it. So much for my cool ending. Doggone it. Sarah says to swim out into the ocean, into the sunset. Nah, I don't know if I can. I gotta find a new car though. So weak.
Wheels, it needs some new wheels.
No can do, lad. Sorry.
Oh, what? How about now?
Frisco Fields and need some new wheels.
Name's Clown at the moment. Give me a ring later on and maybe I can.
Are you serious? I can't get a car to drive out?
Me too. Hope you get mine.
Man, I was trying to end this all cool and poignant. Hey, 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 dog. Hey, 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 hey. Hey, 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 hey. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey.
Ow.
Here we go. All right. As I was saying, sorry, fellas. Go be bankers somewhere else. As I was saying, I think this is the ending. It's my ending. Lincoln Clay is played by Eduardo. Yeah. I can't stay and cause havoc and, you know, the people I care about and are close to, put them in danger. I gotta go.
After Lincoln vanished, Vito Scaletta took over the city. I spit on Sal Marcano's grave one last time by actually doing what Marcano couldn't, finishing the casino. Now, 2 years later, Scaletta opened another casino, and then it was just an avalanche of development. Hotels, arenas, the new convention center. I mean, today everyone knows this place as the Las Vegas of the South, but the whole damn thing was built on bodies Lincoln Clay left behind with blood money he and his lieutenants stole from the mob. And Vito? He still lives in that penthouse at the top of Marcano's casino, looking out over the city he owns. After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. The trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Lincoln made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. Seemed like he was gonna get married, but then it all came apart. Don't know why. And he started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I still get postcards from time to time. You know, I think Lincoln wasn't able to accept the world for what it is, or his place in it.
Someday, he's going to get tired of running, or make a mistake, and I'll be waiting. I promise you that.
Hold my hand. Oh, baby, it's a long way down to the bottom of the river.
Well, there we go. That is Mafia 3. What a cool story. What a cool ending. I like my choice. I think it was a good idea to leave town And I'm not upset that Vito ended up in charge. I ended up giving him a lot of territories to take care of anyhow. I trusted him. He seemed like a cool guy, so that's all good with me. It was a fun story. I think a lot of people could say that it was repetitive, but most video games, if you think about it, they are. You do one thing, and then you do it in another place, and you do it in another place, and that was the thing here with Mafia 3. You'd kind of go somewhere. They'd give you a few area missions. You'd go back. They'd give you a big mission, and it was kind of repeat. But because I enjoyed it and I had a good time, I didn't mind it. I was having fun. So some people complained that it was repetitive, but I was having a good time, so I didn't mind it. If I'm doing something I enjoy, I want to do it again. So that's cool. Hey, big props to the writers of the game. I really like the story a lot. The voice actors did a great job. Animation on the cutscenes and pretty much in general, where the animation was really, really nice, and I really enjoyed it. So, yeah, props to everyone at 2K. Props to everyone who was involved. If you enjoyed the game, if you enjoyed the walkthrough, find someone listed in the credits here. I always say this at the end of the games I play, but I think it's a good thing to do. Find someone in the credits and find them on social media and just send them a nice note, a nice message, a nice tweet. And, yeah, just say something cool to them. Maybe it'll make their day. I thank you for watching. I definitely appreciate it. We've got more games coming soon, so be sure and stick around for those. And in the meantime, you can always find us at marriedtothegames.com. You can find us, the podcast, every week on iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, wherever you... Oh!
Senator! Where were you when John Fitzgerald Kennedy was assassinated?
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
Let me tell you where I was. A muddy hut in Vietnam. Slowly dismembering an old woman. Cutting her apart bit by bit. And do you know why? Because her son was an NVA officer. And hurting her was the only way to make him talk.
I don't understand what this has to do...
What he told us saved the lives of an entire platoon. That's 42 men. Men that lived another day because I was willing to take a saw to that old woman.
Thank you, Mr. Donovan. I believe that...
Sit down and shut the fuck up! I did a lot of terrible shit over there. In the name of this country. Shit that will haunt me for the rest of my life. But I did it because I believed in the fight. I believed what this nation stood for. So, to be sitting there ass deep in mud with that old woman scattered all around me, and hearing that the President of the United States had just been fucking murdered? Well, I knew right then and there that I couldn't let that stand. That I would find a way to make it right, no matter how long it took.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that Sal Marcano and a group of conspirators murdered Jack Kennedy.
Oh, that is the most absurd thing I have ever heard.
I assumed you would say that.
Don't fucking move! You're out of your mind.
Oh, I don't hold anyone's ambitions against them, Senator. And you certainly were ambitious, weren't you? You went to law school, and then you became a district attorney, and then United States Senate. After Sal Marcano died, I went through his files. Imagine my surprise when I saw your name over and over and over and over again! The mob wanted Jack Kennedy dead, and you were more than willing to help.
There are cameras everywhere. There's witnesses.
No, I want
you'll
them
never
to
get
see
away
that, you stupid asshole, because then they will know that I am not finishing with you. I am starting with you. Oh. And they're next. Gentlemen,
God, you're
hurt. That was awesome. Ah, I love that. So cool. Alrighty. Hey, I can't top that. That was awesome. Well done. I'm glad I stuck around. I'm going to let these credits play just because if they worked on the game, they deserve to have their name shown. So let's show them all. In the meantime, thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time. All right, take care. I knew that was Dave Fenoy. Take care, and we'll talk to you next time. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.